3, 2, 1, start.
Good morning, kids. Today is the first day for grade 9 class. And today is also the day 9 of the lockdown. So stay inside, stay safe. Now let us start the first class today. The first chapter is number system. Every year in maths, the first chapter is number system itself. Now you have learnt all the basic stuff. I'm just briefing you today. Now the first is natural number. What is natural number? It's also a counting number. The numbers which we can count. 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. 0 will not come here. We can't say we have 0 apple. So apart from 0, rest all 1, 2, 3 up to infinity comes under natural number. Next is whole number. Whole number is also a natural number, but 0 is included in this. I repeat, even whole number is a natural number, but includes even 0. We represent by W, 0, 1, 2, up to infinity. Now next is integers, represented by Z. So integers include negative number, 0 and positive. I will tell you, see. Next is natural number. Sorry, rational number. So rational number is which can be expressed in the form of P by Q. Where Q is not equal to 0. Why we say Q is not equal to 0? Because if we write 3 by 0, this is not defined. We don't know the value for it. We just write not defined or infinity. We don't know. So, as per the definition, rational numbers are the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P by Q where Q is not equal to 0. This is the reason why we say Q is not equal to 0. Take any fraction, half, 1 by 4. Here even plus and minus both will come, minus 3 by 8, like it goes. Now next is irrational number. Irrational numbers are the numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Like all roots. Perfect square will not come in this. So root 2, root 7, root 3, like that it goes. Now next is real numbers. Real numbers includes all these numbers, whatever we have done now. Natural number, whole number, integer, rational, irrational. All these number comes under real numbers. Now going through all these things, solve NCERT example 1 page 3, you'll be able to do this. Now next, let us come to example 2. So you'll get questions like this. Find 5 rational number between 192. Let us do in a very easier way. In textbook it is given in different way. Now let us do in a very easier way. Now write 1 as 10 by 10 and write 2 as 2 by 10. Now between this, you can write many rational numbers, not only 5. See, we can write as 11 by 12, 10, 12 by 10, 13 by 10, up to 19 by 10 we can write. This is a very easier way of solving. Then, based on this, there are few questions which you can solve in exercise 1.1. Even that, let us discuss now. See, in exercise 1.1, question 2, the question is, find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. So again, write 3 as 30. 30 by 10. Write 3 as 30 by 10 and 4 as 40 by 10. So now we can write many numbers between that. 31 by 10, 32 by 10, 33 by 10, up to 39 by 10. We can write the rational numbers between these two numbers. Now next question in NCERT, question 3, find 5 rational number between this. Now till now we did was all this natural number, now they have given in fraction form. Find 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Now same way, 3 by 5 just add 1 0, we can write it as 30 by 50 and write 4 by 5 as 40 by 50. Now between this you can write from 31 to 39 by 50, you can write so many rational numbers. 31 by 50, 32 by 50, 33 by 50, like that it goes on till 39 by 50. Okay, now let us do some more questions. Now next question is, find
three rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 7 by 8. Now first, before starting this, first see whether denominator is same or not. If not, make it same by taking LCM. See here, the first number given is 3 by 5, other number is 7 by 8. Simple, whatever is denominator here, multiply and divide here. Same way, whatever is the denominator here, multiply and divide here. So you get here 24 by 40, 35 by 40. Now you can write so many rational numbers before, in between this. So it is 25 by 40, 26 by 40, up to 34 by 40. So many you can write. I'll repeat. See here, till now whatever you have done is, denominator was same. But here denominator is different. So question is, find three rational number between 3 by 5 and 7 by 8. First look for whether denominator is same or not. If not, make it same. Very easy. First write the number 3 by 5 and 7 by 8. Whatever is denominator here, multiply and divide here. It will become 24 by 40. It's like taking LCM. Same way, for this number, multiply and divide by the denominator of the other number into 5 by 5. That's it. So it becomes, between 24 by 40 and between 35 by 40, you can write so many rational numbers. Not only 3, many you can write. I'll send few questions based on this. You practice. Meanwhile, I'll also help you. Now, one more concept I have to teach you. The next is, sometimes they'll ask, find one rational number between two numbers. The question will be, find a rational number. So, how to find a rational number? Whenever you come across this one rational number, you just take the average. I'll just tell you now. Find a rational number between x and y. So, answer will be the average of it, x plus y by 2. Let us see some examples. See, find a rational number between 3 by 8 and 2 by 8. So consider this full term as x. It's a rational number, fraction. Be careful. 3 by 8 as x and 2 by 5 as y. So what will be a rational number between this? X plus y by 2. 3 by 8 plus 2 by 5 whole divided by 2. Be careful while adding the rational number. So it is LCM is 40. First terms becomes 15. Second is 16 whole divided by 2. So this is 31 by 40 whole divided by 2 or 31 by 40 into 1 by 2, the answer is 31 by 8. I repeat, see, finding a rational number between x and y, so it is x plus y by 2. 3 by 8 plus 2 by 5 divided by 2. First take LCM for the numerator, LCM is 40. So first term multiply by 5, it becomes 15. Second term multiply by 8, it becomes 16. So this is total up to 31 by 40 whole divided by 2. So 31 by 40 into 1 by 2, which is 31 by 8. So a rational number between 3 by 8 and 2 by 5 is 31 by 8. Now go through this video properly. So I'll send you some more questions to practice. Finish it. Any doubt, please respond. You can ask me any number of doubts in the group. I'll keep replying. Go through this. Start soon. Thank you.